Now I will invite the second contestant, Toastmaster Timothy, with his speech title, Catch the World. Catch the World, Toastmaster Timothy.
It all began in high school. On the very first day, they placed me next to this boy, Jonathan Michael. Jonathan Michael and I were polar opposites. He was dark and handsome, and I was handsome. Only when it was dark. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Toastmasters, contest chair, do you remember looking into the mirror before you were 10? Before that age, I didn't even know what the mirror was. But then along came high school and girls and people, and poof! The mirror became my master. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
Definitely not you. It is him, Jonathan Michael.
I made a wish then. I wanted to look like Jonathan Michael. If I could be as beautiful as him, I could get all the girls and I would live happily ever after. Then, the second year of college in Australia came. From my part-time job, I'd save up enough money. Enough for me to go get some cosmetic surgery. Now I can see from your face, you're probably wondering, which part did he get surgery on? Did it actually work? Come find me later, I'll tell you about it. After it was said and done, bandages crisscrossed my face. Long hair, black clothes, bandaged face. Every time I stepped out, people would go, Asian gangster. Yes, it was fun pretending to be one. So I continued pretending to look all mean and hard with my bandaged face. Until one day, in Chinatown, four huge Asian guys with leather jackets and ripped jeans cornered me. So, tough guy, looks like you know how to fight. No, this is just cosmetic surgery. This is cosmetic surgery. Don't hurt me! After I started working, I had even more money to play with. So I went to a skin doctor, and she suggested laser! I paid her $2,000 to fire laser rays onto my face. Repeatedly. Pain or not? What do you think? After that, I still ask the same question every time. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is it? Still not you. Somebody else. Just give up already. But still, I plodded on. Until that fateful day, my big 3-0. I knew what that meant. I had to learn Photoshop. But then, my best friend, Raj, called me up. Dingy! For your birthday, let's go camping! Let's get back in nature! Whose birthday is it anyway? I don't know what Raj meant by getting back to nature, because in Australia, it's a little bit different to Malaysia. The tent was here, the portable toilet was here, and the hot shower was right here. And I'm thinking, that's better than my house. And the biggest surprise was, I totally enjoyed myself. So the very next morning, I go to Raj and said, you know what, this was actually fun. I think you need to get out of your room more. Stop staring in the mirror the whole day, you wimp boy. But Raj, I'm turning 30. In Malaysia, we say, have to maintain. You think looking good will make your life happier? Well, I hope so. Imagine all that time and money that you can spend doing things that you already know will make you happy, instead of the things that you think or you hope will make you happy. Isn't that better? And then he said something that I'll never forget. If you always go about looking into the mirror like this, then everywhere you go, you only see yourself. But if you turn your gaze outwards, everywhere you go, you see everyone and everything else. First thing I said was, wow, that's really meaningful. Second thing I said was,
want to join my Toastmasters club? That was really good, man. I look forward to your evaluation and speeches next time. Ladies and gentlemen, Raj was right. We are living in an increasingly look-centric society. I put my picture up on Facebook, 20 people like it. I put a picture of a monkey, 87 people like it. Does that mean my friends think I look worse off than a monkey? But I'm still human. I've turned the mirror out and I'm looking out towards the world. Catch the world. But I'm only human and I fail sometimes. My friend, also a Toastmaster, Victor Ong, some of you may know him. Yes, yes, you're shaking your head, yes. So, he likes to come to my club and he takes photos. And I can guarantee that any photo he takes of me, I look absolutely stupid. Then I tell Victor, Victor, is that a problem of your camera or my face? Definitely your face. Ladies and gentlemen, what I'm going to tell you is that you need to turn the mirror upwards. I'm doing the things that I love now, including Toastmasters. I may not look as beautiful as Jonathan Michael, but guess what? When I'm here speaking in front of all of you, I'm turning the mirror upwards, catching the world. You know what I see? I see old friends, I see new friends, I see people with stories. And all of you have stories, and that, seeing you happy, makes me happy. And when I feel happy, guess what? I feel beautiful as well. And sometimes in this suit, yeah, a little bit sexy as well. So ladies and gentlemen, remember the words of Raj. Turn the mirror outwards, catch the world. Because in the end, you are a reflection of what you choose to see. Turn the mirror outwards, catch the world. Thank you.